Today we're going to talk about a very common yet underdiagnosed condition, autonomic neuropathy. Now, what does autonomic neuropathy mean? Neuropathy means nerve damage, and with autonomic, we're dealing with a part of the nervous system that's called the autonomic nervous system, which controls things automatically, which is a combination of the flight or fight stress response and the parasympathetic nervous system, which is rest or digest, and the enteric system, which is another system that can control your digestive system. So that part of the nervous system is on automatic and you don't have to do anything. It just works on its own, as in bladder control, cardiovascular system control. I mean, you don't have to think about your heartbeat. It just automatically works. Digestion and genitals. You may have heard a condition called peripheral neuropathy, where you have damage to the peripheral nerves on the bottom of your feet or your hands. Those are the sensory nerves that get damaged from conditions like diabetes, for example, where your hands or feet get numb, like a burning sensation, or even severe pain. And here's the thing, the number one cause of this condition is diabetes. But if you think about it, you don't just end up with diabetes overnight. It gradually goes from high insulin to insulin resistance to prediabetes to eventually a diabetic, right? Well, you don't end up with this condition overnight either. It gradually occurs. So you may have one or more of these symptoms, and that could be the beginning of this condition. I'm increasing your awareness so you can do something about it before you end up with this condition. Just because you weren't diagnosed with diabetes doesn't mean that it's not related to a blood sugar issue. Another cause of this could be some type of autoimmune condition to part of the nervous system, or maybe even a virus. But diabetes is number one on the list. So let's go through the symptoms. Urinary retention. A lot of people have this symptom, but they never connect the dots with it being connected to maybe a pre-diabetic state or even a blood sugar problem. Number two, hypertension. We know diabetics usually have high blood pressure at some point. Well, now we know why. Then you have number three, abdominal pain or achiness. And that can show up in kind of an uncomfortable feeling in your abdominal area. Number four, malabsorption. This is a real big one. You may not feel this, but it might show up in nutritional deficiencies, which is a whole other series of symptoms. Number five, gastroparesis. This is simply a condition where your digestive system is very sluggish, it's slow, and things just move at a snail's pace. Well, guess what? That's what's causing it, coming usually from this or a pre-diabetic state. Number six, constipation, a very common symptom. Number seven, sleep apnea. Number eight, abnormal sweating. That could be either your body's too dry or you sweat too often. So many people have an abnormal sweating situation. Either they don't sweat enough or they sweat too much. Number nine, orthostatic hypotension. This occurs when you stand up and you get really dizzy, your blood pressure drops too low. Another name for this would be POTS. All right, number 10, arrhythmias. So that would involve the cardio. As far as having autonomic neuropathy of the genitals, that can range from pain to just lack of function of those organs. What can be done about this condition? There's two things that I would recommend. Benfotiamine, which is a fat-soluble B vitamin, which works really good on peripheral neuropathy, but it also is effective in all types of neuropathy, especially if it's related to diabetes or prediabetes, and alpha-lipoic acid. Both of these act as a very powerful antioxidant to repair not only the free radical damage that's coming from this, but both of these are fat-soluble and they support the myelin sheath around the nerve, which is the protecting part. The effectiveness of this and this, I believe, is dependent on if you're also doing keto and intermittent fasting, because this gets at the root of this problem right here. But these two right here would be two really good recommendations for this condition. All right, thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.